Turner.
Oh, it's 20.
Right stage, left girl, second group. Number 37 downstage, number 60 upstage. Upstage, right? Okay, stage left, boys. Let's do the ballet combination. First group of girls, second group of followers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, you're dancing with your tongue again.
Sorry.
Right.
Five, six, seven, eight, one.
Okay, I'm eliminating down. When I call out your number, please form a line. Girls first. Number 2. Number 9. Number 10. Number 23, Judy Turner. Number 37. 149. 152. 179. Cassie. The other girls, thank you very much for coming. I'm sorry. Boys, number 17, number 5, 44, 45. Number 63, 67, 81, and number 84. The other boys, thank you. Larry. Pictures and resumes, please. I want you to tell me your stage name, real name if it's different, and I also would like to know where you were born and when.
Terrific.
Fabulous.
Excuse me, sir. Do we have to? I mean, it's not very polite to ask a lady your age.
Being polite doesn't interest me. Your age does, and I want to know your age. Okay, let's go down the line. We'll start on the end, stage right, please.
26.
Start with your name and step forward.
Oh, my real name's Don Kerr. Kansas City, Kansas. October 20th, 1948.
Next.
Maggie Winslow.
Louder.
Maggie Winslow! Sometimes known as Margaret, Margie, Peggy, all of the above. Whatever it's real, and I was born in San Mateo, California on a Thursday evening at 10:40 p.m. August 17, 1950.
I'm Mike Costa. It used to be Costa Filoni. Born in Trenton, New Jersey, July 9, 1951, which makes me 24.
Next.
Connie Wong. It's always been Connie Wong. I was born in Chinatown, Lower East Side.
Your age?
On this one.
Oh, December 5th, 4,642, the year of the chicken.
Next.
My real name is Sidney Kenneth Beckenstein. My Jewish name is Rachmel Lev Ben Yaakov Meyer Beckenstein. And my professional name is Gregory Gardner. East Side, and I do not deny that. Born August 3rd, 1943.
Cassie, Zach, could I talk to you for a minute?
Sure, go ahead.
Well, I mean, privately?
Not right now, Cassie. I'm running about an hour behind.
Well, I know.
Next.
I'm Sheila Bryant, really Sarah Rosemary Bryant, which I really hate. I was born August 8, 1945 in Colorado Springs, Colorado. And I'm going to be 30 real soon. And I'm real glad.
Joseph Henry Mills III. That's my real name, too. I come from upstate New York near Buffalo. I can't remember the town, I blocked it out. Born March 15th, 1950.
My name is Bibi Benzenheimer, and I know I've got to change it. Born June 6, 1949, I come from Boston, and here I am. My name is Judy Turner. My real name is Lana Turner. No. It's always been Judy Turner. Born July 21st, 1947. Oh, I was born in El Paso, Texas.
Good. Next.
My name is Richie Walters, and I'm from Herculaneum, Missouri. And I was born on a full moon on June 13th, 1948. And I'm black.
I'm Alan DeLuca, January 11th, 1946. I come from the Bronx.
I'm Kristen York. Oh, Kristen Nevlin York. Born September 1st, 1953.
Tell them where you're from.
Oh. I'm from St. Louis, Missouri. Oh, my married name is DeLuca.
I didn't know, Al. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Next.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, I'm Valerie Clark. But my parents think I'm Margaret Mary Houlihan.
Could you just die?
I was born in the middle of nowhere. A little town called Arlington, Vermont. Bye-bye.
How old are you?
Old. No, I'm 25.
Mark Anthony. Really, Mark Philip Lawrence Tabori. Tempe, Arizona. I'm 20.
Oh, jeez.
And if I get this show, I'll work real hard.
Oh, brother. Don't let him bite you.
Paul San Marco. It's my stage name. My real name is Efraín Vermeles. I was born in Spanish Harlem, October 22nd, 1947.
My name is Deanna Morales, and I didn't change it because I figured ethnic was in. 6-10-48. You got that? And I was born on a Hollywood bed in the Bronx.
All right. Go on, Deanna.
Go on what? Oh, you want to know how tall I am or the color of my eyes or how many shows I've done? Well, I just gave you my picture and resume. I mean, everything you want to know is right there.
I know. Now tell me what's not on it.
Like what?
Talk about yourself.
Talk about what?
Tell me about the Bronx.
What's to tell about the Bronx? It's uptown and to the right.
Well, what did you do there?
In the Bronx, mostly wait to get out.
What made you start dancing?
Who knows? I have rhythm. I'm Puerto Rican. I always jumped around and danced. Hey, you want to know if I can act? Give me a scene to read. I'll act, I'll perform, but I can't just talk, please. I'm too nervous.
Well, then relax.
I really don't mind talking, but I just can't be the first. Please.
You want the job, don't you?
Well, sure I want the job.
All right, Deanna, back in line. Before we do any more dancing, and we will be dancing some more, let me explain something. I'm looking for a strong dancing chorus. I need people that look terrific together and can also work together as a group. But there are some small parts that have to be played by the dancers I hire. Now, I have your pictures and resumes. I know what shows you've been in, but that's not going to help me. And I don't want to give you just a few lines to read. I think it would be better if I knew something about you, about your personalities. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask you some questions, and I want to hear you talk. Treat it like an interview. I don't want you to think that you have to perform. I just want to hear you talk and be yourselves. And everybody, just relax as much as you can. Sheila?
How many people do you want?
4 and 4.
44? No, 4 and 4.
4 boys, 4 girls.
Need any women?
Okay, Mike, I'll start with you.
Me? Don't you want to start at the end?
No, I'll start with you and relax.
I could if you started at the end. What do you want to know?
What do you want to tell me?
I like to tell you to start at the end. Oh. I can't think of a thing.
Oh, yes, you can. What was your family like?
Oh, well, I come from a big Italian family. My grandmother was always hanging out the window, leaning on a little pillow, because that's what Italian grandmothers do, hang out windows. I was the last of 12. I was an accident. I was. That's what my sister told me. Oh, that was his sister, Rosalie. She's the one that started taking the dance lessons. My mother used to take her every Saturday. She used to take me along. I like going.
How old were you?
4. I used to sit the old perky end. I'm watching Cisco pitter-pat. Said, I could do that. I could do that. Knew every step right off the bat. Said, I could do that. I could do that. One morning, Sis will go to dance class. I grab her shoes and tights and all. But my foot's too small, so I stuff her shoes with extra socks. Run 7 blocks in nothing flat. Hell, I can do that. Calling me Twinkle Toes.
Did that bother you?
Nah, I figured let them say what they want.
Oh, I don't buy that, Mike.
Oh. Well, sure it bothered me. I don't want anyone calling me Twinkle Toes just because I took a couple of dance lessons.
Okay, Mike. Back in line. Bobby, you're on.
Well, actually, I don't know how I turned out as heavenly as I did. See, when I was 5 years old, I was playing jacks, and the car fell down on my head.
Bobby, you're gonna do a routine.
No, no, moving right along, moving along. Let's see. Do you want to hear about all the wonderful and exciting things that have happened to me in my life, or do you want the truth?
I'll take the truth.
Well, to begin with, I come from this quasi-middle-upper, upper-middle-class family-type home. I could never figure out which, but it was real boring. I mean, we had money, but no taste. You know the kind of house, AstroTurf on the patio. Anyway, my mother had a lot of card parties and was one of the foremost bridge cheaters in America. And my father worked for this big corporation. They used to send him out into the field a lot to drink. Better that than to find him lying on his office floor. Oh, but he was okay. I was the strange one.
How strange?
Real, real strange. I used to love to give garage recitals. Bizarre recitals. This one time I was doing Frankenstein as a musicale, and I spray painted this kid silver all over. They had to rush him to the hospital because he had that thing when your pores can't breathe. Anyway, he lived because luckily I didn't paint the soles of his feet. And
what if I'm next? What if I'm next? What am I gonna do? I haven't got a clue. I gotta think of something. What does he want? What does he want? Stories from the past. I'd better find one best.
What should I say? What can I tell him?
As I got older, I kept getting stranger and stranger. I used to go down to this busy intersection near my home at rush hour in direct traffic. I just wanted to see if anybody noticed me. Oh, that's when I started breaking into people's houses. Oh, I didn't steal anything. I just rearranged their furniture.
And Orphanage 3, mother and dad both gone. Raised by a sweet ex-con. Tied up and raped at 7. Seriously, nothing to obscene. I better keep it clean.
What should I say?
about school. I went to P.S. shit. Well, I was the kind of kid that was always getting slammed into lockers and stuff like that. Not only by the students, by the teachers, too. Oh, and I hated sports. Hated sports. And sports were very big. I mean, it was Jock City. But I didn't make one team. See, I couldn't catch a ball if it had Elmer's glue on it. And wouldn't my father have to be this big ex-football hero? He was so humiliated. He didn't know what to tell his friends, so he told him I had polio. On Father's Day, I used to limp for him. And...
God, I'm a wreck. I don't know where to start. I'm gonna fall apart. Where are my childhood memories? Who were the boys? What were my toys? Gone beyond recall. And why am I so tall? What should I say?
What can I tell him?
And my mother kept saying, if you don't stop burning up your brother's toys, we're going to send you away. And I was always thinking up these spectacular ways how to kill myself. But then I realized to commit suicide in Buffalo is redundant.
Okay, Bobby. Back in line. Sheila.
Yes? You want me?
Yes.
He wants me.
To talk.
Right. What do you want to know about me first?
Why are you in this business?
Well, I wanted to be a prima ballerina. That light. What color is that? Do you have anything softer?
Don't worry about the light, Sheila. Just talk.
Well, like I said, I wanted to be a ballerina because my mother was a ballerina. Until my father made her give it up.
Sheila, come downstage. Closer.
Can I sit on your lap?
Do you always come on like this?
No, sometimes I'm aggressive. Actually, I'm a Leo.
Well, what's that supposed to mean?
It means the other 11 months of the year have to watch out. I'm very strong.
Maybe, too strong.
Am I doing something you don't like? I mean, you told me to be myself.
Just bring it down.
Bring what down?
Your attitude. Tell me about your parents.
My parents?
Your father.
Him.
Your mother.
My mother. My mother was raised like a little nun. She couldn't go out. She couldn't even babysit.
Sheila, don't perform. Just talk.
But she wanted to be a dancer, and she had all these scholarships and all that, and when she got married, my father made her give it up. Isn't this exciting? And then she had this daughter, me, and she made her what she wanted to be. And she was fabulous the way she did it. You want to know how she did it?
Yes. But first, your hair.
What? You don't like it.
No. Let it down.
That's what I've been trying to do. Better?
Better. Go on.
Oh, how she did it. Well, first she took me to see all the ballets, and then she gave me her old toe shoes, which I used to run down the sidewalk in. On my toes. At five. And then I saw the red shoes. And I wanted to be that lady, that redhead. And then when she saw that I really had to dance, she said, you can't do it till you're eight. Well, by then I was only six. And I said, but I've got to dance! I mean anything to get out of the house.
What?
Nothing.
What did you say?
I just said that I wanted to get out of my house.
Why?
The truth?
Sure, you're strong enough.
Well, let's face it, my family scene was, not good. Daddy always thought that he married beneath him. That's what he said, that's what he said. When he proposed, he informed my mother he was probably her very last chance. And though she was 22, though she was 22, though she was 22, she married him. Life with my dad wasn't ever a picnic, more like a come-as-you-are. When I was 5, I remember my mother dug earrings out of the car. I knew that they weren't hers, but it wasn't something you'd want to discuss. He wasn't warm. Well, not to her. Well, not to us. But everything was beautiful at the ballet. Graceful men lived lovely worlds in one. Yes, everything was beautiful at the ballet. I was happy at the ballet. That's when I started class. Up a steep and very narrow stairway to the voice like a metronome. Up a steep and very narrow stairway. It wasn't paradise. It wasn't paradise. It wasn't paradise, but it was home. Mother always said I'd be very attractive. With a special something and a very, very personal flair. And though I was 8 or 9, though I was 8 or 9, though I was 8 or 9, I hated her. Now, different is nice, but it sure isn't pretty. Pretty is what it's about. I never met anyone who was different who couldn't figure that out. But it was clear, if not to her, well then to me, that everyone is beautiful at the ballet. Every prince has got to have his one. Yes, everyone is beautiful.
I did have a fantastic fantasy life. I used to dance around the living room with my arms up like this. My fantasy was that it was an Indian chief, and he'd say to me, Maggie, do you want to dance? And I'd say, Daddy, I would love to dance.
But it was clear when he proposed.
Warm, not to hurt. He
Christine?
Oh, no. Me?
That's what he said. Come on.
Oh, God. I don't know where to begin.
Tell him where you started.
Oh, well, everybody says that when I was little, every time they put on the radio, I just get up and start dancing. And, oh, this man came around to my house selling,
Lessons.
Yeah. Oh, he was a terrific salesman. I'll never forget it. He put me up against a television set. It was one of those great big square things. And then he turned me around, picked up my foot, and touched it to the back of my head, and said this little girl could be a star. Well, I don't know if it was the look on my face or the fact that I wouldn't let go of his leg. Oh, my mother saw how much he meant to me. I mean, I've watched everything on television, and I'm dancing on it, especially, oh, God, every Sunday I was up.
Ed Sullivan!
Right, Ed Sullivan. Every Sunday, like church. And then I, oh, dear, what was I talking about?
Ed Sullivan.
No, it's, oh, right, Ed Sullivan. I'm sorry, it's just I'm really nervous.
Well, that's all right. Just take a minute and pull yourself together.
For her, this is together.
Oh, he's right. But anyway, I always knew what I wanted to do. I wanted to be like all those people in the movies. Only it's funny, I never wanted to be Ann Miller. I wanted to be Doris Day. Oh, but I have this little,
problem?
Yeah. See, I really couldn't sing. I could never really sing. What I couldn't do was
sing.
I have trouble with that
note
because all around my throat is a terrifying
thing.
See, I really couldn't hear which note was lower or was
higher.
Which is why I disappear if someone says, let's start a
choir.
Hey, when I begin to
squeak,
it's a cross of
shriek,
and a quiver or a
moan.
It's a little like
throat,
a
throat, the throat,
but it doesn't happen. Oh, I know you're thinking, what a crazy
thing.
Sing,
three blind mice.
Three blind mice. It is unintentional.
She's doing her best. Jingle bells, jingle bells.
Jingle bells, jingle bells. It really blows my mind.
She gets depressed.
But what I lack in pitch, I sure make up in
power.
And all my friends say I am perfect by the shoulder.
Back in line. Mark.
Well, I get the feeling most of you always knew what you wanted to do.
Me? I didn't. I was just a kid for a while. And then one day, well, my father had this fabulous library in back of the house. And when I was about 11, I guess, I found this medical textbook. Well, it had pictures of the male and female anatomy and, well, I thought this was pretty interesting. I used to read that book a lot.
Were you interested in medicine, or were you just into the pictures?
Hello, 12.
Hello, 13.
Hello, love.
Change is old.
Now we love.
Time to die.
Too young to take over, too old to ignore.
Gee, I'm almost ready
my own appendicitis. Next day I went to our doctor down the block. Sure enough, acute appendicitis. Well, they rushed me right to the hospital. Well, I figured this book would cover everything the rest of my life. When I was 13, I had my first wet dream. I went right back to the book. A milky discharge. Milky discharge, milky discharge, milky discharge. Gonorrhea! Well, I was in shock. I mean, gonorrhea before it even started. I mean, I was terrified. I couldn't tell my mother I had gonorrhea. Well, so the book said, drink a lot of water.
Is that all the book said?
No, it said take penicillin, something or other. But I couldn't do anything about that unless I told somebody. So all I could do was drink the water, and I drank like 20 glasses a day. For 3 weeks, I almost drowned. Well, finally I went to confession, and I told the priest that I had gonorrhea. He was in shock, too.
Who have you been with, my son?
Nobody. Nobody.
Then how can you have gonorrhea?
Well, I told him about the book's diagnosis for milky discharge, and he set me straight. It's the only time the church ever helped me out. Well, I was
4 foot 10, 4 foot 10. That's the story of my life. I remember when everybody was my size. Boy, was that great. But then everybody started moving up. And there I was. Like at 4 foot 10, 4 foot 10. But I kept hoping and praying. I used to hang from a panel bar by the hour, hoping I'd stretch more. Cause I was into dancing then, and I was good. And I wanted so much to grow up to be a prima ballerina. Then I went out for cheerleader, and they told me, no dice, you get lost on the football field. And little pots are beginning you. I spent my whole childhood waiting to grow
tits. When am I gonna grow tits?
Secret. My whole life was a secret.
One little fart! Then they call me stinky for 3 years!
I'm gonna be a movie star.
But you see, the only thing about me that grew was my desire. I was never gonna be Maria Tolchi. I was just this peanut on point. That was my whole trip by side. It still is Gavin. I show was 32 and about a 14-year-old rat.
Aha! Year of the chicken. 32?
And I should not be, because I've always been able to work. From the time I was 5 in King and I, up till now I've never stopped. Because whatever I am so excited, because I'm going to go to the High School of Performing Arts. I mean, I was dying to be a serious actress. Anyway, it's the first day of acting class, and we're in the auditorium, and the teacher, Mr. Carp. Anyway, he puts us up on the stage with our legs around everybody, one in back of the other, and he says, okay, we're gonna do improvisations. Now, you're on a bobsled, and it's snowing out, and it's cold. Okay, go.
I had inside. Yes,
Lessons on one. Actress, never. Jesus Christ! Went to church, praying Santa Maria.
I lied about my age, so I could join AGWA, you know, the nightclub union, because I could make $60 a week working these strip joints outside of Kansas City. I worked this one club for about 8 weeks straight, and I really became friendly with the stripper. Her name was Lola Latours, and her dynamic twin, 44s. Well, she really took to me. I mean, we did share the same dressing room. Anyway, she used to come and pick me up and drive me to work nights. Well, the neighbors would all be hanging outside of their windows, and she'd drive up in this big pink Cadillac convertible. Then smile. And I'd come tripping out of my house with a little tuxedo on and tattoos in my hands. And we'd drive off down the block with her long, flaming red hair just blowing in the wind. I told him about this big romance we were having, but actually, she was going with this.
Little brat, that's what my sister was, a little brat. And that's why I shaved her head, I'm glad I shaved her head. But then my father lost his job, so we had to leave El Paso and wanted to visit Louis, Missouri. Well, it was the furthest thing from my mind to be a
ashamed of your own mother? But the thing that made my daddy laugh so much was when I used to jump and dance around the living room.
Please take this message to Mother from me. Carry it with you.
And take Mom to Roseland. She'd come home with the shoes in her hand.
Father's side of the family, it's the ugly side.
Wait until your father gets home.
Where he got home to die.
And it was the first time I'd ever seen a dead body. But then when I was 15, the most terrible thing happened. The 10 Mac Amateur Hour held auditions in St. Louis. And I didn't hear about it till after they had gone. And I nearly killed myself. I tried to walk in front of a speeding streetcar. And I remember noticing boys for the first time. Anyway, I remember practicing kissing with Leslie. She was my best girlfriend. Did any of you ever practice kissing with another girl so that when the time came, you know how to?
No.
Oh. Well, Jody, did you go?
Yeah.
Just a couple of times, though.
Oh, count me in.
Thank God. Anyway, I do remember that.
The worst thing in school was every time the teacher called on me. I'd be hard. Really, I'd have to lean up against the desk like this. And the teacher would say, stand up straight. I can't. I have a pain in my side. Stand up straight. Or walking down the hall, you'd have to walk like this. With all your books stacked up in front of you.
Yeah, I thought it was only me. I thought I was a sex maniac.
You are.
I did too. I mean, it didn't go down for 3 years.
On the bus. The bus was the worst. I just look at a bus and... Bingo! And then there was the time I was making out in the back seat with Sally Ketchum. We were necking, and I was feeling her boobs, and feeling her boobs. And after about an hour or so, she said, ooh, don't you want to feel anything else? And I suddenly thought to myself, no, I don't.
did that come as a surprise to you?
I guess, yeah. It was probably the first time I realized I was homosexual. I got so depressed because I thought being gay meant being a bum all the rest of my life. And I said, gee, I'll never get to wear nice clothes. And I was really into clothes. And this pair of powder blue gowns.
What am I gonna say?
I kissed the folks goodbye, got in a Trailways bus, and headed for the Big Bad Apple. June Allison, right? Because I wanted to be a rockette. Oh, yeah. Let's get one thing straight. See, I never heard about the red shoes. I never saw the red shoes. I didn't give a fuck about the red shoes. See, I decided to be a rockette because this girl in my hometown, Luella Heiner, had actually gotten out and made it to New York. And she was a rockette. Oh, well, she came home one Christmas to visit, and they gave her a parade. Goddamn parade! I twirled a friggin' baton for 2 hours in the rain. Unfortunately, though, she got knocked up over Christmas and never made it back to Radio City. No, but that was my plan. New York, New York, here I come! Except I have one minor problem. See, I was ugly as sin. I was ugly, homely, skinny, unattractive, and flat as a pancake. Get the picture? Anyway, I get off this bus in my little white shoes, in my little white tights, in my little white dress, in my little ugly face, in my long blonde hair, which was natural then. I look like a fucking nurse. The mayor would be waiting for me at Port Authority. Wrong. I had to wait 6 months for an audition. Oh, well, finally the big day comes, and I show up at Radio City Music Hall with my red patent leather tap shoes, and I do my little tap routine. And this man says to me, "Can you do fan kicks?" Well, sure, I could do terrific fan kicks, but they weren't good enough. Of course, what he was trying to tell me was that it was the way I looked, not the fan kicks. So I thought, fuck you, Radio City and the Rockettes! I'm gonna dance on Broadway! Well, Broadway, same story. Every audition. I mean, I would dance rings around girls, and I'd find myself out in the alley with the other rejects. But after a while, I caught on. I mean, I had eyes. I saw what they were hiring. I also swiped my dance card once after an audition. And on a scale of 10, they gave me for dance 10. For looks, 3. Well, dance 10, looks 3. And I'm still on unemployment. Dance for my own enjoyment. That ain't it, kid. That ain't it, kid. Dance 10, looks 3. You'd like to die. Left the theater and called the doctor for my appointment to my teeth and ass. Bought myself a fancy pair. Tightened up the derriere. Did the nose of it.
Yeah. No, sir.
Would you step out of the line? When did you start dancing, Paul?
Not until very late.
Why?
I don't know why, I just didn't.
Well, what did you do?
Nothing much.
Oh, come on, Paul, you must have done something. How old were you when you did start dancing?
16.
Well, what did you do up until the time you were 16? I mean, what was your family like?
We were close.
Close, brothers, sisters?
Two sisters, one died when I was 14.
How?
I really don't want to talk about that. I mean, why do I have to talk about that?
Larry, can we please sit down?
Zach, can the kids sit down now?
And smoke. Can the adults please smoke?
All right, everybody take a break out in the hall. Paul, we'll try this again later. Cassie, stay on stage, please.
Interesting, isn't it?
Yeah. What are you doing here?
What do you think? I need a job.
In the chorus?
Look, Zach, I'd love a part of the chorus, but I'll take what I can get.
You're too good for the chorus, Cassie.
Too good? Wow. I did a couple of dance.
You were featured. So... You stopped two shows cold. Your career was going fine here in New York.
I can't get a job, Zach. God, you sound like all my friends, my fans, acting like I'm a star and don't know it. When the truth is, I never even came close, and nobody has the guts to tell me. Well, it would be nice to be a star, but I'm not. I'm a dancer. Give me somebody to dance for. Give me somebody to show. Let me wake up in the morning to find I have somewhere exciting to go.
So you're going through a slow period. It happens to everyone. Something will happen.
Oh, that's what I kept telling myself in California. And I kept telling myself that and telling myself that. Well, nothing will happen. I can't act.
What?
I can't act. And there I am in California, supposed to be this actress. Well, it didn't take me long to find out. I can't act. And it didn't take Hollywood very long either.
You didn't work out there.
Oh, sure. A rotten part in a so-so film. Part ended up getting cut. Thank God. I was a go-go dancer in a TV movie of the week. Let's see. Oh, yes, commercials. I almost got to squeeze a roll of toilet paper, but I lost out in the finals. Isn't that something? 17 years in the business, and I end up flunking toilet paper squeezing. And I was a dancing Band-Aid. That was fun. We had an earthquake. And I got a terrific tan. Oh, and Shirley, you must have heard about...
I did hear you going out with some big agent, being a bit wild, running around, carrying on.
Well, when you're a woman of leisure, what else is there to do but get a bit wild and run around? Not to mention getting fat and going crazy. Which is why I came back to New York. Which is why I am here today, Zach, old dear. Little pussycat. I need a job. I can believe in, to have someone to be. Use me, choose me.
I just can't see you dancing in the chorus, Cassie.
Why not?
Listen, if you need some money, call my business manager.
Sure, I need money. Who doesn't? But I don't need a handout. I need a job. I need a job, and I don't know any other way to say it. Do you want me to say it again?
No.
Fine. Then we got that far. Look,
I haven't worked in 2 years, not really. And there's nothing left for me to do, so I'm putting myself on the line. Yes, I'm putting myself on your line. I don't want to wait on tables. And what I really don't want to do is teach other people how to do what I should be doing myself. God, I'm a dancer. A dancer dances. Give me somebody to dance with. Give me a place to fit in. Help me return to the world of the living by showing me how to begin.
All I ever needed was music and the mirror and the
start over, Zach. I'll settle for that, starting over.
Starting over?
Yes.
We can't.
We can't. Well, you're talking about...
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. You're talking about us.
Cassie, let's just keep this business, okay?
By all means. Well, who was here for anything else? That's what it's all about, isn't it? Work, Zach. Well, that's why I came here today, about work.
Well, you shouldn't have come. You don't fit in. You don't dance like anybody else. You don't know how.
But I did years ago. And I can do it again. You're not even letting me try? Please. Just give me a chance.
Does Zach want the kids back now?
No. Take the kids down to the basement and teach them the lyric to that number. Oh, send Paul in. All right, go with Larry and learn the lyric.
Thank you.
Wanted to see me?
Paul, yes. I really like the way you dance, Paul. No, I mean it. And, I figure we give this one more try. Now, tell me, for one thing, if you're gonna change your name, why go from a Puerto Rican name to an Italian one?
I don't look it. People say, you don't look Puerto Rican, you don't look Puerto Rican. But I am.
So you figured you looked Italian?
No, I just wanted to be somebody new, so I became Paul San Marco.
Why'd you want to become somebody new?
Why? I'm not exactly proud of my past.
Who is? But that's what the word means, Paul. Past.
It might be easy for you to say, but...
Wait a minute. What made you start dancing? Your parents?
No. What do Puerto Ricans know about theater? Now they have Channel 47, but... Well, then they didn't have anything. My father loved movies. He would take us all the time. He worked nights, and he'd come home, and he'd take us to 42nd Street, and we would come out of one movie, and we would go to another and another movie. I don't know why, I just love musicals.
How old were you?
7 or 8.
On 42nd Street?
Yeah, it was a trip.
Go on.
I'd have to move down front because I couldn't see. I wear contact lenses now. I'd move down front, and these strange men would come in and they'd sit beside me and play with me. I never told anyone because... Well, I guess it didn't matter.
Why didn't it matter?
Why?
Look, Paul, if this is rough, you don't have to say anything more because I haven't...
No! Okay. From seeing all those movie musicals, I used to dance around on the street, and I would get caught all the time. God, it was so embarrassing. I was always being Sid Charisse, always, which I don't really understand because, you see, I always wanted to be an actor. I mean, I really wanted to perform. And once my cousin said to me, "You'll never be an actor." And I knew that she was telling me this because I was such a sissy. I was terribly effeminate. Oh, I always knew I was gay, but that didn't bother me. What bothered me was I didn't know how to be a boy. And one day I looked at myself in the mirror and I said, "You are 14 years old and you're a faggot. Now what are you gonna do with your life?" By that time, I was in Cardinal Hayes High School. Well, there were 3,000 boys there. I had no protection anymore, no homeroom where I could be charming and funny with the tough guys so that they'd fight my battles for me. Like when I went to small schools. I liked school, but my grades got so bad. I mean, even if I knew the answers to questions, I wouldn't raise my hand because I'd be afraid that they'd laugh at me. They'd even whistle in the halls. It was awful, just awful. And finally, I went to the principal's office and I said, I am a homosexual. Well, it was a Catholic high school at around 1962. Well, at the age of 15, you just didn't say that. And they said to me, would you like to see a psychologist? And I did. And he said, I think you're very well adjusted for your age, and I think you should quit school. So I did. But I didn't really want to. I couldn't take it anymore. You see, when I quit, what I was doing was I was trying to find out who I was and how to be a man. I mean, you know, there are a lot of people in this world who don't know how to be men. And since then, I found out that I am one. I was looking for the wrong thing. I was trying to learn how to be butch. Anyway, I started hanging around 72nd Street, meeting all these really strange people. Just trying to make friends that were like me so I could understand what it was that I was. And somebody told me that they were looking for male dancers for the Jewelbox Revue. You know, the drag show. So I went out to audition. Now, from all those years pretending to be Cerise, I had this fabulous extension. I mean, I could turn anything, my first audition. And they said to me, you're too short to be a boy. Would you like to be a pony? And I said, well, what's that? And they said, a girl. And I said, well, what do I have to do? And they said, show us your legs. But I have hair on my legs. It's okay, just come on upstairs. So I went. Well, they hiked up my dungarees and they put on a pair of nylon stockings and high heels. I mean, it was so freaky. So incredible. And then they brought me back downstairs and they said, oh, you have wonderful legs. And I said, oh, really? Terrific. You know, it's so strange thinking about all of this. I mean, it was a whole lifetime ago. I was just past 16. Well, then there was this thing of me trying to hide it from my parents. Now that was something. I mean, because I had to buy all this stuff, you know, like shoes to rehearse in, earrings, makeup. And I would hide it all and my mother would find it. I told her that there was this girl in the show who didn't want her mother to know what she was doing and I was holding the stuff for her. She believed me. Well, I was finally in show business. It was the asshole of show business, but it was a job. Nothing to brag about. I have friends. But after a while, it was just so demeaning. You see, nobody at the Jewel Box had any dignity. Most of them were ashamed of themselves and considered themselves freaks. And I think it was the lack of dignity that got to me, so I left. Why? I muddled around for a while. I worked as an office boy, a waiter. But without an education, you can't get a good job. So when the Jewel Box called and asked if I would come back, I went. Anyway, we were working the Apollo Theater now on 125th Street, doing four shows a day with the movie. I mean, it was really tacky. Well, the show was going to go to Chicago, and my parents wanted to say goodbye, and they were going to bring my luggage to the theater after the show. But we were doing this Oriental number, and I looked like Anna Mae Wong. I mean, I had these two great big chrysanthemums on either side of my head, with this huge headdress with these gold balls hanging all over it. And I was going on for the finale and going down the stairs, and who should I see standing at the stage entrance? My parents. They got there too early. I freaked. I didn't know what to do. And I thought to myself, I know, I'll just walk quickly past them like the others and they'll never recognize me. So I took a deep breath and I started down the stairs and just as I passed my mother, I heard her say, oh my God. Well, I died. But what could I do? I had to go on and do the finale, so I just kept going. After the show, I went back to my dressing room, and after I'd finished dressing and taking my makeup off, I went back downstairs. There they were, standing in the middle of all of these. All they said to me was, please write. And make sure you eat and take care of yourself. And just before my parents left, my father turned to the producer and he said, take care of my son. That was the first time that he ever called me that.
That you just learned. Now this is important. I want to see unison dancing. Every head, arm, body angle exactly the same. You must blend. This is one of those numbers where you back the star. You're the frame, and I don't want anybody to pull my focus. Now let's review what starting position is. Turned in third. Hips and shoulders are on the back. Chest up, elbows up, chin front, eyes are straight ahead. A 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, 1.
Step up, step and step one. makes. One smile and suddenly nobody else will do. You know you'll never be lonely with you. No. Thank you.
need one of them. They're wonderful.
But you're special.
No, we're all special. He's special, and she's special, and Sheila, and Richie, and Connie, they're all special. I would be very happy to be dancing in that line. Yes, I would. And I'll take Horace. You'll take me.
All right, who are we going to hire?
I don't know.
So what do you want to do now?
Start matching them up. Do the tap combination.
Okay, the tap combination. A 5, 6, 7, 8. Sheila and Bibi, stand by. Boys work upstairs with the girls just a bit.
Yeah.
Oh.
Little injury?
Well, he just had it operated on. That's sure it's his cartilage.
I called doctor.
No.
Now you should call a doctor.
Paul, who's your doctor?
I don't want a doctor.
Paul, who's your doctor?
Call Sydney Rhodes, 595-7639.
All right, call.
Dr. Sydney Rhodes, 595-7639. You know, maybe you should prop something under his knee.
All right, give me a dance bag.
It's okay, I think I just twisted it. Oh, shit.
Is that better?
Does anyone have a Darvon or a Valium or anything?
I do.
Can I use some water? You're gonna be okay, Paul. You're gonna be okay.
Yeah, but that'll work, huh?
Look, I don't think you should give him that. You don't know what's wrong.
Please, I've had three already today.
Zach, the doctor says it'd be quicker if we got him in a cab and went to St. Joseph's Hospital than if he came here. He'd be waiting for him at the emergency entrance.
Right,
I'll go.
No,
look, I'll help you.
All right, fine. Let's work together. Let's get him up. You ready? One, two, three, go.
Easy, easy.
Put your arm around me. Where's his dance bag?
Which is his?
Are you all right? Paul, I'll see you later. You call me from the hospital.
Well, I have a wife and two kids, and as much as I love dancing and theater, it's
It's all about paying the bills now and getting the kids through school. I mean, I have to go where the money is.
What are you gonna do?
I'd like to stay in the business. Maybe stage manager. Someday direct it.
Hello?
Whatever, I'll just have to see, that's all.
Oh, I can't think of anything else I do.
Well, if we all had to pick another career, go on, pick a career. What would you like to be when you grow up?
Yeah. Have a bunch of kids dance around my kitchen cooking and enjoy getting fat.
That sounds good. Oh, except the fat part. Gee, I'd like to do that. Just not right away.
Listen, all I want to be is just happy.
Oh, come on. Aren't you happy? Look, I sit around and get depressed and worry about all these things, too. But then I meet somebody and say to me, wow, you dance on Broadway. How fabulous. You got somewhere. You're something. And Christ, I get this feeling inside. When I used to stand outside of that stage door, and I'd watch all these girls come out of there with their eyelashes and their makeup, and I'd think, God, I'll never be that old. I'll never be that old. I'll never be old enough to come out of that stage door. But deep down inside, I knew I would, and God damn it, I've come this far. I'm not giving up now.
That's what I used to say. I won't give up. I've got to be a ballerina by the time I'm 18. Then I found out I should be in musical comedy and said, okay, I'll be a chorus girl, but I've got to be playing parts by the time I'm 21.
Oh, no. Did you do that, too? Give yourself a time limit?
I still do it. Right. And then you're 25, and you say, just a couple more years. Well, hell, I'm 30. I mean, how many years do I have left to be a chorus cutie? 3, 4, if I have my eyes done. Well, I don't want to deal on that level any longer. And just lately, I've been thinking about opening a dance studio. I don't know. Am I copping out? Am I growing up? I don't know.
Who does? Listen, who knows anything? It's just something you're gonna have to wait and see.
Right. But if today were the day you had to stop dancing, how would you feel?
Thank you.
start eliminating, I just want to say that I think you're all terrific. And you've been wonderful about going through all of this today. I sincerely wish I could hire all of you. But I can't. Will the following people please step forward? Don. Greg. Al. Deanna. No, I'm wrong. Back in line. Christine. Bibi. Sheila. Connie. Maggie. Frontline, thank you. Thank you very much. I'm sorry. Begin September 22nd. We will rehearse for 6 weeks with a two-month out-of-town tryout. Our New York opening will be sometime mid-January. Be prepared to sign a standard minimum contract with a six-month writer. You'll be contacted sometime next week as to where and when to sign your contracts, and I'm very glad we're going to be working together. Thank you.